It's the final chapter of the season then here at the spectacular Yas Marina Circuit. It's a race where the pole sitter failed to finish in three of the first four events. A front row start here is by no means a guarantee of victory, so we go into battle once more as we get underway at the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. The drivers will be racing here at the Yas Marina Circuit through 21 corners and a lap distance of just over 3.4 miles. There are a few opportunities to pass, with long straights and DRS zones in two places, turns 8 and turn 11. Plenty of close racing then, plenty of speed, and I hope plenty of drama to be found in the laps ahead. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Perez, Charles Leclerc, the owner driver, Coulthard, Ricciardo, Giovinazzi, and Lance Stroll, Russell, Norris, Yuki Tsunoda, and Schwartzman. Ocon, they've taken a grid penalty. Sainz, Nikita Mazepin, and Fernando Alonso. Latifi, Tictum, Gasly, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Mick Schumacher. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
It's been a roller coaster season then, but they can go into the winter with their heads held high after an emphatic victory here today. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalize on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently. It's clear to see that they've put in the work and they should be proud of the victory they secured here. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Fernando Alonso. Wherever he is, whatever team he's in, when is he not just brilliant? He'll give you a performance every time, just like he's done today.
With that result, the sport's newest team can no longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many had written off a short time ago. They are Formula One World Champions. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, and an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
So that was an exciting race from our perspective. Let's have yours.
Podium finish for your teammate. Will you be celebrating with them tonight? Why do you think you weren't as quick as your teammate today?
Great. Well, that's everything.
The team's income is looking very robust right now. It's time for you to have a think about our profit margin and what areas of the operation might benefit from that money.
Here we are in the HQ of our newest Formula One team. We've got an awful lot to talk about, so let's jump straight in. We've seen ex-driver Lucas Weber has been spending quite a lot of time with your team recently. We understand he's been working as some kind of consultant. What's that been like? According to your latest quarterly report, your team is very cash rich. Now, is that a safety net, or are you sick? Your facilities here are looking a little dated compared to other teams. Is there a reason for that? You lost your second driver due to financial issues. How dire is the situation at your team? We've not seen much in the way of development for your second driver. Do you feel that you don't need to, or do you feel that they've already reached their potential? It's been wonderful to spend some time with you. Best of luck out on track.
You're not currently in a rivalry. Sooner or later, you'll probably be asked by the media who you consider to be your rival. Think carefully who you select, as while you will receive a claim for beating them, you'll lose a claim if you fail to do so.
We've got an issue we'd like your input on.
Thanks. I appreciate you taking the time to help out.